Improving the soil on your farm begins with knowledge. If you're going to be successful at building healthy soil, it's important to understand the principles and forces that nature uses to produce healthy plants. Keep in mind that soil is a living system. Each ounce of a highly functioning soil contains hundreds of millions of microorganisms and tens of thousands of individual species.
It's not easy. You have, in this type of system, you have to think more, because there's a lot of biological energy that we can capture instead of bringing chemical inputs. And as chemical inputs become more expensive, become more limited, we want to capture nature's way of farming.
Growing plants are the channel through which energy from the sun is transformed into chemical, biological, and mechanical energy for the entire soil building process. Plants shade the soil from sunlight, while plant leaves and stems prevent erosion by softening the impact of falling rain and moderating damage to the soil from wind. Plant roots play a major role in the process of building healthy soil. Let's take a closer look at what the roots of plants do. Plant roots enable water to penetrate the soil and allow it to retain moisture more efficiently. The roots themselves help break up compacted soil. As plants grow, their roots secrete chemicals that support a vast array of microorganisms. These organisms are vital to healthy soil. They decompose organic matter, take up nutrients, and recycle these nutrients, making them available to plants. Soil organisms also work with plant roots to provide glomalin, a kind of soil glue which improves soil structure.
And this soil feels very, very fluffy. It has a very fibrous root system, which goes a long way towards controlling erosion and recycling nutrients, and also improving the health of the soil.
When soil is tilled, all of these biological processes are interrupted and soil building shuts down. With no live plants in the ground, the organisms working to produce healthy soil lose their habitat and many of them die.
Tillage is like somebody coming to your house and knocking the house down with a bulldozer. It took years and years to build that home. It takes a long time to build the soil ecosystem. So to me, the most important thing about it is understanding how your soil system functions. Nature wants to cover itself. It's a strange thing for nature to be uncovered.
Plants and plant roots do much of the work of building healthy soil, but nature also uses another tool, surface residue. By covering the surface of the soil, residue moderates the force of rainwater. Residue also protects the top layer of soil from wind erosion. Surface residue works to regulate temperatures on the soil surface. Covered soil remains cooler in the summer and warmer in the winter. Plant residue creates habitats attractive to earthworms and other organisms that are good for the soil. Plant residues also contribute organic matter to the soil. When we say soil organic matter, we're talking about plant material in various stages of decomposition. SOM is produced over time by living plants and their residues, along with the organisms that decompose the plant material. In healthy, undisturbed soil, SOM tends to be present at levels much higher than in conventionally tilled soil. Soil organic matter is capable of storing large amounts of water. 1 pound of SOM can absorb and retain 18 to 20 pounds of water in the soil. SOM has a dramatic effect on soil fertility. You can think of it as a bank for soil nutrients. For example, each 1% of SOM contains 1,000 pounds per acre of nitrogen. Healthy soils with high levels of SOM continuously cycle nutrients and make them available to growing plants. Soils with high levels of organic matter produce high nutrient efficiencies and will save you money on fertilizer. Now let's take a look at one more element found in all healthy soil, good soil structure. Healthy soil is well aggregated. This means the soil particles and organic matter are clumped together to form aggregates. These aggregates remain stable. They're able to hold together through cycles of wetting and drying. Along with the lumps come pore spaces that keep the soil well aerated and allow water to infiltrate. These pore spaces make it easy for plant roots to penetrate deeply into the soil. In the same way that tilling destroys organic matter in the soil, it also breaks down soil structure. Tillage also produces conditions where it's hard for soil-building organisms to survive. And while plowing a field before planting does temporarily loosen and aerate the soil, tilling destroys soil aggregation and leaves it vulnerable to erosion and compaction. For the remainder of this series, we'll talk about the strategies of using cover crops, reduced tillage systems, and crop rotations, managing nutrients and cropland pests, and the new techniques of precision agriculture.